Hello everybody, this is your host LandyX, and I am welcoming you to a new game. Well, I mean, it's not a new game per se, but a game that most of you probably haven't heard about. I didn't know about it until, I don't know, a week ago. That being said, it's a game called David, and I'm just going to let David speak for himself right now. I have actually already beaten the game. Not entirely. I've beaten all the main levels. There's some side things that I haven't done yet. But anyway, I'm just going to restart it from fresh so that you can get the story. And I can go through all the infuriation that this game will bring me. So anyways, here goes with a new game. As you see, it's going to override everything that I already did. But yes, I'm sure for y'all, I will do this. So here goes. And it's a little bit of a cutscene. And that is the evil. This is the quote-unquote narrator. There's no voice in this game. There is evil. But this is David. And David obviously is you. I'm not going to sit here and read everything else. I'm sure y'all have your own voices in your head that do that for you. But, yeah. So we're a confused box right now. That's what we are. And something sparkly and shiny is coming down to touch us. I'm still not entirely sure what that is. I'm really not. I beat the game. I don't know. But anyways, this is your means of attack. This is actually makes it incredibly interesting. It looks kind of stupid right now, but it is one of the most interesting features to a game I've seen in a long, long time. Sorry for not walking around right now. I was trying to get a drink and then it decided to make me move. Now, one thing that I'm going to show off that it won't tell you is it's going to make you, you know, try to do the stereotypical jump and all that. Now, that's just me tapping it. That's me holding it. All right. The longer you hold the button, the higher you go. And say I get here and then hit it again. I can basically perpetually fly should I choose to, which actually comes very much in handy later on. And it's trying to tell you here to hold the jump to jump higher. But, yeah, you can just fly over it. It's, yeah. So anyway, so it's just telling you to keep going, and whee! And see, it's like trying to introduce the idea of a double jump kind of thing, like so that you can sort of fly like I was talking about. Doors are usually your main objective throughout the game. It's one of those simple games where it's just get to the door, you know. That's usually what it boils down to most of the time. That being said, what's down here? So that's bad. So it says kill this thing. And basically what it does is our gift. Now as you can tell, it slows down time. Now, one of the pieces, I didn't jump while I was slowing down time, so I kept falling. I should have jumped like this and shot it. So one of the pieces, oh, and that's also another thing. When you release time, you've got to be incredibly careful how much you actually press that button, because you will keep going farther than you think you will. That being said, one of the pieces of that little creature thingy, majigger, hit me and took a bit of my health. So that's important later on when we get into the harder levels, and I'll demonstrate that later. So I'll go slow so that y'all can read this. You know, your foes may outnumber you, and your size may seem far too small. But you must use your gift to confront the evils of this world, David. And then you keep going, and it gets really bright and white. And you will prevail, for you are from me, and I am with you. Keep going. Oh, gosh. And see, here's basically your hub. So you've got basically the entire kind of idea, I think, is the idea of sin. Kind of getting the feeling that the creator of this game was probably Christian. And these are like the seven deadly sins. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so there's an extra one in there because of wolf. Well, actually, no. I don't know if all of those are deadly sins, but some of them are like the seven deadly sins. That being said, you know, I mean, this is your basic hub. I'll show this off as well. There's an arena up here, which is kind of interesting. I didn't really get too much into it. I don't know if you can see my mouse right now. I hope you can see my mouse pointer. I don't think you can. I think my Bandicam settings are off. But anyways, this is Mar. So there's like 5 more levels here. We'll get to those later. Those are a lot different than the normal levels that you'll play. So we'll jump those hurdles when we get there. We're going to go back and we're going to start all the way down here at Greed. Now, I'm going to do it on okay. Okay is basically easy, and then very is hard. There is no medium in this game at all. There's no normal. It's just, it's either ridiculously easy or it's stupidly difficult. So we're going to do okay just so that I can kind of show... Oh, God. He's already attacking me. I forgot about this guy. See? Ow. Because I was being stupid, I already died. This guy likes to pin you in corners. The entire thing... Ow, you jerk. I thought you couldn't hit me. You don't want to get greedy. Like, I don't want to be down here taking as many shots as I can take, because he will eventually hit you, right? So the trick that I found is to just hang out just above him. He can't jump. He can hit those little ramps right there, but outside of that, he can't do anything. So you just keep chipping away, and he eventually dies, right? See, I went, and then, you know, the entire idea is to get it done in the fastest amount possible and get to the door, right? Okay, so that was Greed on Very. Now, you see, I get a diamond here, which corresponds to a square here. So, that being said, there's 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16 diamonds, and 16 diamonds here. That also corresponds to this here. I didn't realize this until just now, but you got to get to a certain point to unlock the arena. But anyways, basically, so you get all 16 diamonds. Oh, no. Nope. I'm not doing that one right now. You get all 16 diamonds, and it unlocks the final level, which is Sin. Anyway, so that being said, we're going to go back and do Greed on Very, and you'll see the difference here. Oh, gosh. See, I already died. I keep doing that. I get greedy. I think that's kind of the point. But anyways, also, I'm talking, which, yeah, doesn't help. But anyways, see, Very drops you down to 1 health bar. Alright, now I don't worry too much about time, so if you want me to try to do like a speed run, I can, but I'm not going to right now. I'm just demonstrating the game. It's a game that I enjoy. And this one, I know that he's going to follow me, so I know that basically the way the AI works, especially with this particular enemy, is it's just going to keep trying to attack me no matter where I'm at. So if I move over here, it's going to follow me. And if I stay there, it's going to stay there. So it's just going to stay directly below me trying to hit me. So I know exactly where it is at all times. And you have to wait for it to charge up. Ooh, wait, did that just regenerate? I think that thing just regenerated. That's kind of terrifying. But anyway, so that's where the levels get difficult, is when you start playing them on Very. Because you only have 1 health. So basically, you only have 1 shot to do what you got to do. Now, Anger made me angry. Well, actually, this one wasn't too bad. Wolf made me mad. but you'll see why in just a minute. Wolf and Flea are the 2 most annoying levels in the game. Okay, so like I said, same thing. We're going to do it on okay, and then we're going to do it on Very. Now, see, this thing immediately starts chasing you, and then he tries to start shooting you in the face. The purple thing, basically, is... It launches them. And see, I've already taken a hit. I would have already died on Very. But anyway, so, I mean, like I said... Oh, and I'm going to show you another thing that's kind of cool that I remember. There's a door somewhere. See, it's Lol. Oh, come on. Get in the door. Get in the freaking door. Why are you not getting in the door? Okay. Anyway. So there's that. So, it's basketball. It's a game within a game. Boom. And if you look at the scoreboard, there's like somebody with like 10 million points. Sir Bigby Chick, you spent way too much freaking time on this game. I'm just saying. Unless you figured out like some magical way of playing this game that I just haven't. You spent way too much time on this game. But anyways, so yeah, I mean, that's just like the little mini game. As far as I know, that's the only one that's in this game that I know of. But yeah, you're like, if you ever get this game, which I do highly recommend it, it's pretty great little time waster for as cheap as it is. And, I mean, it lasted me probably a solid, I don't know, 2 hours, because I played it once on a friend of mine's computer because he was showing me, and then I went out and bought it because I was so, like, impressed with the game. But anyways, so now this is your exit, and it's going to take you back to your base, right? But, yeah, see, like, it technically, like, didn't complete the level because I didn't exit through the proper door. So, yeah, just don't do that on Vary. Oh, no, see, like, and it just kind of, like, all the parts are sort of random a lot of times. So they will just end up, like, murdering your face if you don't do it right. That's why I just kind of continue to go all the way up here, shoot where I know it's coming. Oh, see, like, it's stupid. Oh, and another very, very interesting thing about this is when you click that button to start your slingshot ability, it slows down time, which is very, very useful for stuff like this. And the more you use your ability, the more your little sprite things get spread out, so the harder it becomes to use. You have to work on the timing. The bigger the mass you shoot out, the more it takes out in one shot. If you start shooting, like, the little tiny ones, it's just going to take out one apiece, and then it's going to come right back to you. It's not going to do anything. That being said, I like to try to attack this one around corners. See, like you said, sorry. Oh, no, it shot me. But, like, it did the little rectangle signifying that I could shoot, but when I let go, none of the sprites were in there. So I couldn't actually shoot. That's something that you got to be very mindful of, and you can't get in too much of a hurry. You can also use your shots to deflect the purple one if you're good, but it will just change. And see, like I just got trapped in the corner right there because I didn't move. I got greedy. So it's easier with this one just to keep moving. Try to like make it come around corner. Oh gosh. See, like this. This one makes you mad because it's smart. Especially when you go around this particular block here, it just spreads out and like just tries to murder your face. It's just it's like it learns almost. It's ridiculous. I remember playing this for like a solid hour, or not like a solid hour, probably like 15-20 minutes easy, and that thing just got better every time I played it. I swear, either that or I just got dumber. I don't know. But, I'm just failing because I'm talking, so I'm going to shut up and I'm going to beat this thing right quick. I'm going to try to, anyways. He just, like, touched me. Screw you. This is why it's called anger. It actually gets very, very difficult. Oh, no. I misclicked. Dang it. All right. I will beat this thing. I swear I'm better at this game than people think. See, like, it, like, split up and, like, I don't know. That was stupid. It gets smart. It's scary. Get out of here, purple. Get out of here. Stop it. And another thing is, it will shoot periodically. So you can wait for it to regroup. I don't know. I think there's only two of them. Yes, I got it. Alright, so there's that. So yeah, a little trick for that one is just move out of its range, let it shoot, it'll regroup, and then just shoot it before it can shoot you again. Now here comes the most infuriating level in the game to me, outside of Flea. Flea is a bear in and of itself. Wolf, out of all like the levels that I actually like, this one's the most annoying. And you'll see why. Oh my goodness. Excuse me, guys. Sorry about that. All right. So we're just going to do it on a case that I can demonstrate it. I probably won't do very right now. All right. So these are your wolves. You got a big wolf and a little wolf. Both of them are jumping at you. Both of them have boxes. Ow. Ow. Awesome. Okay, I'm already almost dead. You see what I mean? Like, even on okay or whatever this is, it's still freaking annoying. Because you got to kill the box. Then you got to kill what's inside the box. And it's just, it's stupid. Like, it's incredibly difficult, especially on Vary. Because, like, everything gets more aggressive on Vary as well. So it's really kind of stupid and ridiculous and just annoying. Okay, so there's a big box. Now we got to get the little box. Little box is usually easier because there's not as many things that you need to kill. Oh, come on. Let me shoot you. And that's what I'm saying. You got to watch your timing because if you notice, everything spreads out. So it's not like I'm just shooting one clump usually. You gotta work on that timing, which is something that's... Oh, I died on okay! But anyways, yeah, the timing you have to work on. You have to just get a feel for what you're doing and know how much you're working with. Anyways, I'm gonna let that death be it. That's a demonstration of David. I will continue this Let's Play. Or walkthrough, Let's Play, whatever you want to call it. It will continue because I thoroughly enjoy this game. I recommend anybody that's looking for a little bit of a time killer to go out and buy it. I do not remember exactly how expensive it was. Let me see if I can, I was going to see, but there's no way to get into the actual market and I don't want to show off my desktop to get to it. I was going to see if I could look up the price for you. But it's not very expensive. I think it was like $8, maybe $7.99, something like that. So that being said, it's a good hour's worth of gameplay. If you're bad at games like I am, maybe two. It's fun. It's very, very unique. I highly recommend it. 4.5 stars out of 5. Probably, you know, 4.5 just simply because it's not longer. You know, it's only like 8 levels plus the more levels, you know. So there's not a whole lot to the main game, but at the same time, it's a blast to play. I remember when I first started playing this, I had the biggest smile on my face for a solid hour until I got into the level flea, and then it just made me mad. But that being said, I think everybody should look into this game. It's on Steam. I think, like I said, it costs like $7.99. So if you got like a spare $10 lying around, go check it out, seriously. That being said, this has been your host, LandyX, and I will see you in the next video.